into the fourth quarter, a 10-point lead, and, you know, we just wanted to hold that. We knew that they were going to be desperate and come out and play. But, you know, for us, you know, we just wanted to win the game at all costs. So we defended well, and then, you know, some shots fell.
At the very end of the game, after that timeout, you sat out those last couple of possessions. What was the decision behind that?
Just preserving my body. You know, I felt like we had it in a good place. We believe in our team. We believe in everybody in here. So, you know, 2 days to get right, and then we're back in Milwaukee.
There were a couple of unsung heroes potentially that showed out tonight. Mikal Bridges potentially being number one. When he is playing like that, what does that do to elevate the rest of this group?
I mean, we need that. You know, it takes a lot of pressure off of everybody. You know, he has a tough assignment every night on the defense end, guarding Chris Middleton or whoever the dynamic scorer is that night. And, you know, if we can get him going on the offense end, you know, it helps us out a lot.
The Milwaukee Bucks, they've come down from 0-2 before in these playoffs. What do you all need to do to keep the momentum going heading back to their home territory?
I mean, it's a 0-0 mindset for us going into game three. You know what I'm saying? It's a game seven for us. Every game is a game seven at this point of the season. So, you know, we're locked in. We understand it's a really good team over there. We know it gets rowdy in Milwaukee, but, you know, I think we're ready for it.
Thanks so much, Devin.
Thank you, Malika.
Mike, back to you.
All right, Malika. They're a splashy, fun offensive team, but they were also a tough, gritty defensive team. Booker part of that. As the Phoenix Suns take game two, 118 to 108. Booker 31, Bridges at playoff high 27, Chris Paul 23 and 8.